Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered into the city of Al-Madinah, we mentioned that one of the first things that he said was afshu salam. He called out to the people of Medina and he said afshu salam, spread salam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he continued his address to the people. Remember, it was to the people of Medina, not just the Muslims, but also included non-Muslims as well, because when the Muslims migrated, they were in fact a minority in the city. So the Prophet ﷺ said, "Afshu salam wa at'imu ta'am." Such a beautiful statement. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Go and feed the hungry, feed the poor and needy." This is one of the second things that the Prophet ﷺ shared. So from this we learn, subhanAllah, that when we are, you know, amongst our community members, we should always look out for those who are less fortunate. We should always look out for those who possibly they might not have food. And we should also look out for the brothers and sisters, the rest of them in the Ummah who are also struggling with, you know, things like starvation. So the Prophet ﷺ said, go and feed the hungry, whether that's your own guests, feed them. Whether that's, you know, poor people, feed them. Whether that's a homeless person in the street, go ahead and feed them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this beautiful characteristic within the believers in Surah Al-Dahr, where he says that وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. That the believers, one of their qualities is that they feed other people only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of their love for the poor people, for the orphans, for the captives. And Allah says, these same people, they say, إِنَّمَا نُطَعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. We only feed you for the sake of Allah. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We do not expect from you any gratitude, any thanks, nor do we expect any reward back from you. SubhanAllah. So this is the reason why we should feed people only for the sake of Allah, not expecting anything back in return. So this is one of the things that the Prophet ﷺ shared. Al-ta'imu ta'am. Another thing that the Prophet ﷺ shared, he said, wasilu al-arham, that go ahead and maintain your family ties. He said, go ahead and maintain your ties of kinship. Again, something so important, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions this in the Quran, where he says, وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَن يُوصَلْ. That the evil people, the wretched people, are those who they cut the ties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them to maintain, told them to keep. So again, this is very important. Keep your ties of kinship. There might be many of us who haven't spoken to our relatives, who haven't spoken to our family members for a long time. Maintain these family ties, because this is a command from the Prophet ﷺ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about these people, وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. By doing this, they have actually caused corruption and mischief in the land. How? Because if families are broken, then what happens is that communities also become broken. If the family ties are cut, then the ties amongst the people in the larger community and society will also become cut. And one of the final things that the Prophet ﷺ said was وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامٌ. And whilst all the people are sleeping in the night time, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, this is a beautiful piece of advice. Why? Because this is something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself encouraged us to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encouraged us to do. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَتَهَجَّدْ بِهِ نَافِلَةً لَكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and for some portion of the night, the believers, they pray to Allah tahajjud as a nafil, as something additional on their behalf. So if we really want something, what we should do is we should wake up in the middle of the night and we should beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this. We should make dua, we should pray to Him. Or at the very minimum, what we should do is before we go to sleep, we should pray at least, you know, two raka'at, raka'atain, and make dua, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever it is. And inshaAllah, through this, we will get the reward of tahajjud and we will also get the reward for qiyamul layl. This was the address of the Prophet ﷺ to the people of Medina, one of the first khutbas, one of the first pieces of advice that he relayed to them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to follow this, inshaAllah ta'ala. Follow it word for word, because by following this piece of advice, whether it's salam, for example, which is something that relates to the whole, you know, globally, to all the people, whether it's feeding poor people or the hungry, this relates to something in our community. Whether it's silul arham, you know, maintaining ties of family kinship, this relates to families. And if it's to do with prayer, then this is something that is to do with your own personal development and your own spiritual development. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us. وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.